Hello there and welcome. My name is Siddharth Shah. In Think and Grow Rich, there are these six basic fears which we talk of. And one of the fears which is very much relevant right now in the current context is the fear of ill health. Fear of ill health. In fact, I just did a Facebook Live on this particular topic, but it was a more of a Hindi-English combination. But this video is completely in English. And so you get this in a nutshell, that what is this fear of ill health, and check yourself, do you have this particular fear of ill health? So if you want to understand any particular fear, you need to understand the symptoms associated with that particular fear. And those symptoms are visible in your daily behavior. How do you behave in your daily routine, in your 24 hours? And now if you are focusing on the fear of ill health, that do I have the fear of ill health? Now let me give you some of the symptoms which could be there, and just check whether you have them or not. And I'm going to create for them all the five symptoms, and let's roll it out. The first symptom which you should check yourself is what I call as the fear of auto-suggestion. A symptom which is like auto-suggestion. What is auto-suggestion? Auto-suggestion is a self-suggestion. It's like the inner voice inside you, which keeps on talking to yourself all the time. And you need to be aware of what's your inner little voice speaking to you. And I'll give you some examples. You'll say, oh, this can happen to me also. Oh, I sneezed. Oh, it's a cough for me, or is it something connected to what is happening right now in the world? And that little voice, that inner voice doesn't stop. It keeps on cramming. And sometimes you just get fed up about it. And if you're not present with that small little voice, which we call as auto-suggestion, perhaps you have got the fear of ill health. And remember, friends, I'm not saying don't take precaution. You got to take utmost precaution. You got to take utmost care of yourself. But there is a very thin line between fear and taking precaution. So I am going to give you what is the distinction between the fear and the precaution. So take precaution. So the first symptom is auto-suggestion. The second symptom which check yourself whether you have the particular fear of ill health is what I call as hypochondria. What is hypochondria? Hypochondria is fear of imaginary illness. So you start imagining things that maybe I don't wear full sleeve shorts, even then I'll get exposed to this virus. Well, that's imaginary. Maybe you've not done proper research on this, and you're just imagining it. Or maybe you would imagine that if I don't wear the proper gloves also all the time, or maybe you are doing some things which are not at all relevant to this particular virus to be spread. But you are making imaginary things, making your imagination go wild. And perhaps if you're doing that, if that is your behavior, then you have got the symptom of hypochondria and you have got the fear of ill health. So that's the second symptom you need to check. The third symptom which you need to check yourself in your daily behavior is susceptibility to what others are speaking about you or telling to you directly. So maybe you meet someone, or maybe you are on a Zoom call with someone, on a video call with someone, and say, hey, you're looking a bit different today. Something is wrong with you. Just be careful, you know, the way things are running around. And you would say, no, I'm absolutely fine. And maybe after a couple of hours, you would speak to someone else, maybe on another Zoom call. And the other person also says the same thing to you. Hey, something is different with you. Kuch to gadbad hai. I mean, something else is there with you. And you would say, why you are also saying about this? And maybe after a couple of hours, again, the different person will say the third time to you, hey, something is wrong with you. I mean, you're not looking the way you are looking normally. Well, now what you would do? You would go to your washroom and check yourself. Hey, yeah, seriously, something is wrong with me? So you are actually susceptible to those influences. And rather than judging or maybe evaluating yourself on a rational basis, your mind is prejudiced because of this susceptibility. So if you have got this particular symptom, perhaps check yourself. You also have the fear of ill health. The fourth symptom which you need to check yourself is what I call as the fear, or maybe you are at the symptom of intemperance. Intemperance, what do you mean by intemperance? Intemperance means you go to the extreme. You're not rational. Maybe if you have got a fear, maybe you got fever, simple. But you just pop up painkiller pills. But you will not go to the doctor to check yourself and get the right analysis done and get the right medicine for that. maybe you will just resort to some kind of a stimulant. Maybe it could be alcohol. That okay, if I have a couple of drinks, I'll be normal. You become intemperate. Well, you should not become intemperate. I mean, if you got a particular virus, go to the doctor, check yourself, and take the normal precautions which are going to be taken. You don't need to be, weird about things in your life by being intemperate about it. And perhaps if you are being intemperate, if you are bathing yourself with alcohol sanitizers, perhaps you are being intemperate. So think, check your behavior that you should not become intemperate. And if you are being intemperate, maybe you have got the fear of ill health. That's one of the fourth symptoms. And finally, the fifth symptom, which I think is very, very relevant right now, is what I call as the habit of reading about the illness. Reading about the illness, maybe reading on WhatsApp, on Google, and maybe on so many of several social media platforms, on TV news channels. I'll tell you, you don't need to become a doctor or a PhD in coronavirus. You don't need to become that. I mean, you will not, even if you get all the information in the world, John Hopkins University is not going to call you and say, okay, we're going to put a doctor in front of your name. No. I mean, if you want to become aware of what's happening, I'll give you a tip. Give about 10-15 minutes a day in the morning and about 10-15 minutes a day in the evening. And just be aware of what's happening around. And just that's it. Then just shut it off. I mean, it's no point in just being on red alert like a news reporter every 5 minutes of what's happening around in India or in the world. So don't, if you're doing this, perhaps you've got the fear of illness, the fear of ill health. So check yourself, you know, don't be bombarded with the news. Become a master of your field, become a master of your industry. That is going to carry forward once the things become normalized. So again, I just a quick recap, the five symptoms of ill health. The first, we have got autosuggestion. The second, we have got hypochondria. The third, we have got susceptibility. The fourth, we have got intemperance. And fifth, we have got the habit of reading about illness. Check your behavior. If you find yourself having any of these symptoms, perhaps you have got the fear of ill health. Master this particular fear. Take utmost precaution, but don't fall into the fear of ill health. And if you are doing it for your own self, you do your bit. Maybe somebody else will also see this video and does that. That person does his bit, and you are actually spreading this across. So I want your cooperation, that you are going to like and comment this video and share across your groups, across your WhatsApp groups, like a virus. So people understand that this is not the way I want to live my life. This is not the way I want to live this particular fear of ill health. Because the only way you're going to stop this virus to spread is by you taking precautions and not living under the fear of ill health. Okay. If you like my video, subscribe to our YouTube channels, share the word across. Stay at home, stay safe, stay healthy. My name is Siddharth Shah. Thank you very much.